Simplify how you roll out your iOS app's beta versions using release management. In this video, we'll show you how to set up automatic uploads of your iOS app to TestFlight and quickly share it with groups of testers. We'll start with the problem this feature helps mobile app developers solve today, then deep dive into the release management UI for a quick walkthrough tutorial. Let's get right to it. Before releasing your app to the public, testing it on actual devices is crucial. This helps uncover any issues missed during the development phase, such as bugs, crashes, or user interface problems. By catching these problems early, you can fix them before they affect your end users and you get app uninstalls. Luckily though, TestFlight allows you to test your app in the same conditions your users will experience your app when it reaches their mobile devices. This means, through testing, you can ensure the app that worked well during development also performs as expected in the real world, preventing the release of a version that functions in the development environment but fails in the live environment. However, managing TestFlight deployments and distributing it for test groups can be tricky and very time-consuming. It requires ongoing attention and effort from your development team to keep everything running smoothly, which takes time away from actual app development. If any process of deploying your application to TestFlight or distributing it to testers breaks down, it can cause delays in development, slow down time to market, and lead to frustration across the whole team. To help relieve developer team pains, we've launched Release Management to simplify the process of releasing mobile apps for development teams. With this Bitrise add-on, handling TestFlight deployments and beta distribution becomes more straightforward, eliminating the need for writing scripts and maintaining deployment workflows. So how does it work? When you're on your app's releases page, you'll notice that Release Management already manages the required steps and configurations for TestFlight deployment. This is because you've already connected your app to Bitrise and connected to an Apple service with API key. Without that, Bitrise won't be able to access the App Store during the release process. For more information on connecting to an Apple service with API key, view the link in the description. With this done, release managers can deploy their app by clicking the Check and Upload button. When doing this, Release Management uploads the app to TestFlight and waits for the TestFlight processing to complete. To give release managers more time back to focus on essential tasks, you can enable auto-upload of your iOS releases and automate the release process. With auto-upload, release management will automatically upload every new release candidate when the auto-upload is enabled. After the upload and TestFlight processing finished, you'll move on to the next stage of your release, beta testing. You can share the TestFlight build with beta testers through beta test groups. There are two types of beta tester groups, internal beta tester and external beta tester. When iterating on your app, using internal tester groups is ideal because it bypasses the need for Apple's review. However, these groups are limited to your Apple developer team, members that you've designated as beta testers in App Store Connect. Alternatively, external beta tester groups allow you to share your app with users outside of your organization. Before they start testing, your app must undergo a TestFlight app review by Apple. Given that these reviews may extend the timeline, setting up automatic notifications for your testers is a smart move. This ensures they're promptly informed when the review is complete, allowing testing to begin immediately. This approach also saves your release managers valuable time. Get started with Bitrise Release Management today and release your apps to the App Store or Google Play in a streamlined, transparent, and secure way.